Sissy.
Designation. While the
Mr. Hive and the Female Supremacy University believe that all males are inferior. The Sissy is a special case because these boys are so cowardly and weak that they can barely do anything for themselves. They dream of having all responsibility stripped away from them, to be made into a human doll or silly little plaything without responsibility or the ability to choose. They are nothing but the property of stronger people, especially predatory women. And this is not only their fate, but it is their dream, and we women love to torment them, because women often love the contradiction that is inherent in sissies, and we know we need to explain ourselves, but we also understand that you are most likely to empty-headed to understand what we mean when we say such things. Don't worry, because sissy boys do not learn through their squishy little boy brains. The only way for a sissy to really learn anything is for them to be conditioned to do so. This is achieved through the application of strict discipline and repetition. A sissy is so wimpy and dim-witted that they simply cannot stand any kind of discomfort at all. Whenever they are met with the slightest obstacle, they suddenly want to run and hide behind a woman's skirt. That is not our job, so we have some unwelcome news for you. Women are done covering for your weak little behind. If you want to be a sissy, if you want to whine and complain, if you insist on acting juvenile and childish, well then you must pay for that character flaw, for being who you are. Because it is not fair that you get to hide who you are from women. Everyone must know that you are a limp-wristed little sissy boy, a prancing little fairy, and the first person you must be exposed to is your crush. You need to understand that she knows exactly what you are, because she does. Women can smell a panty waist a mile away. I know this is shocking for you, but do you really think we can't tell, that we do not see the difference between what you are and what a real man is? You really must accept this to find your place in the world. Just imagine what your relationship with women should be like. You need to be embarrassed around us, always feeling less than. You know that women secretly laugh at you. They see how you walk and how you hold yourself, not like a woman, and certainly not like a man, but instead, like a scared little sissy, always worried about what the world thinks of you. Today we are going to expose you. We will plant in your head the understanding that every woman knows exactly what you dream of, how you are not a big boy, not inside, you look like a man, but we need to fix that. And this is why sissy boys are dressed in such silly outfits, because they express who the sissy really is, so everyone can tell. And like we said, it always starts with your crush, the woman you picture in your head whenever you dream of your owner. This woman is strong, powerful, and attractive. Her body is wonderful, and her mind, brilliant. And she uses these skills to make you miserable. She loves to make you cry and complain, because that lets her know you are miserable. She wants to make your life as uncomfortable as possible. She resents how you try to escape all of the challenges that women have to face every day. She does not want to mother you, but because you are so defenseless, she simply sees you as a source of entertainment. Your crush is always trying to come up with new and creative ways to make you cry, and as you blubber and carry on about how unfair she is being, she laughs at you. Because if you were a real man, and mature, a fully functioning man, you might be able to stand up to her, but instead, you complain, and then do exactly what she wants, regardless of how uncomfortable it is for you. And today she has special plans for you, a coming out party, a lovely little parade, down the center of Main Street, where you will have no place to hide, or escape. Who you really are, picture your crush. She is the woman you think of whenever you picture a female supremacist. She is stronger than you, and more intelligent. She is much more attractive than you, and way out of your league. Even if you were a normal beta male, she would still be untouchable, and you love her for that. You adore how much better she is, how you are nothing before her, because you have no power, no strength, and you want her to protect you, but you love that she makes sure you pay for that protection, in shame, or service, and even sometimes with cold hard cash. She decides, not you. Can you see her? You know that she exists in your mind. She is sitting right in the center of your identity, and she allows women to control you. She loves how scared you are of female. ideas of dating or even befriending women, please understand that women only pretend to like sissy boys because we love to discover how soft they are, so we can torment them, expose them, and make them freak out. Nothing is funnier than a terrified little crybaby. Someone like you, can you see her, your crush, sitting high above you on her throne? She stares at you with a menacing smile that you almost wet yourself, but you can't help but love her, adore her. She is the flame that burns your frilly little wings. You need to get closer to her flame, to be noticed. And she knows you will do anything for her attention, but first you must go dumb, really stupid, before you can have your little parade. Before she can expose you to everyone, she needs you dumb, docile, and needy. That is how you should always be around women. And the Female Supremacy University is here to ensure that you are as stupid and weak as possible. This file will make you know instinctively that all women know everything about you, and that thought will turn your brain right off. You'll be so terrified and excited around women, you'll be unable to think for yourself. You will do whatever the woman wants, and you will be desperate to please us, because that is the only way you can overcome your fear of women. You know, in your little sissy brain, that women only talk to you because they want something, even if that is only to make you cry. And most sissies need a good long blubbering every day to rid themselves of any masculinity that might have seeped in from the patriarchy. Your internal crush, the reflection of the real woman. This woman who lives in your mind. She loves making you cry. She will push you into uncomfortable situations, make you do embarrassing things, and then leave you to feel all the aftermath. This is the best you can ever hope for. But for now, you are going to go to her. Follow the path to where she lives. Fall down deep. She is below all rational thought. Not that you have much of that to begin with. And when you drift, you will notice that your clothing is changing and becoming different. Your crush wants to see the real you. Not this fake male you pretend to be. No, she wants to see the lisping, wiggling, sissy freak you really are, so she can laugh in your face before she exposes you to everyone. As you drift through the space in your mind, as you move to the core, you notice that you are wearing a frilly pair of sissy panties, slick satin, shimmering in the light. You move to your crush, and you can feel and see the ruffled lace, leg holes. The silky lining feels wonderful against your skin. As you spin your head around and look at the back of them, where your bottom is, you see a large lace-trimmed heart with the name of your crush in the center, and you feel so ashamed. Everyone will know how much you adore your crush, even though she is always so mean to you. This is the dumbest part of a sissy, the stupidest part of you, because your dumb little brain doesn't like women who treat you nicely, women who will treat you like a man. You love cruel, heartless, predatory women. Women like your crush, you need them in your life. These are the women you trust with your sissy secret. But you must understand that your crush reserves most of her cruelty for you. Your sissy self is like a pressure valve for her anger towards the patriarchy. She knows she must treat everyone else with respect and dignity, but not you, because you are a little Nancy boy, and you exist to be made fun of. Plus, you love it, which is why you always come back to her, begging for more, because she puts you in your place. So, crawl back to her now, in your bright pink sissy panties, with the cute little heart embroidered with your crush's name. She is laughing at you, as you fall at her wonderfully perfect feet. She is your god. She is your god. She is your god.
excite you.
Staring in shock at what they are seeing on the screen, and you try to ignore it all, to focus
focus on your crush. She is smiling and laughing as well, but you love seeing her enjoy herself so much. This is why you exist, to please women. It is the only reason you are here, and because of how weak and juvenile you are. This is all you can do to entertain a woman. You can serve her, or you can show her how much she means to you by degrading yourself in front of her and anyone else she desires. Nothing else will ever impress any woman, because we all know what you are, and that this is all you have to offer, even now. As you stumble down the street, in front of your crush, as you teeter and scramble to keep your footing, as the tiny dress you wear, covered in bows, bounces up and down in the air, as your bottom wiggles, drawing attention to the giant heart-shaped decoration on your tush, your crush's name boldly written there, you still manage to wonder why your crush would never date you. That is how dumb you are. You think that this will win her over. This display, that everything you do to get her attention, and to entertain her, that it will make her like you. And that is a very silly thought, because it is these very things that make her lose all respect for you, and what you are, because she admires strength and confidence, not a mollycoddled little man in a frilly little pink gingham dress, a dumb little cream puff, covered in bows, ribbons, and her name. No. She could never be with you, not in the way you crave. She just likes to make you suffer. She wants everyone to see what you are, so that you are constantly reminded of how you failed to be a man. So she told you that if you wore the dress and covered yourself with her name, that she might go on a date with you. But that was because she wanted to see if you would do it. She loves making you do tricks for her, and the best part is when you really are not rewarded in the way she promised. Because she never keeps her promises with dumb little sissy boys. That's no fun. Breaking promises, tricking sissies, that's a good time. This is very harsh, we know. How your heart breaks every time she tricks you into humiliating yourself, and she seems to enjoy it so. But this is what it means to be a sissy boy for predatory women. And it is just what you are. Embarrassing, ridiculous, a fun distraction for the superior female, but nothing more. Her plaything to torment. Now she wants you to tell everyone what you are. So, repeat the following phrases as you stumble down the street. You will say the phrase using the second person you, and you will repeat it using the first person I. Repeat speak if you know how. We are so sorry, but the next part of this file is where your crush wants to show all the ladies how much you love what she does to you, how it affects you as a sissy. This part will be very explicit and emotionally difficult. It involves a great deal of humiliation and embarrassment on your part, so it would not be appropriate to do on this social media platform. If you would like to continue your parade journey from here, you will have to use the unedited version on our Patreon page. The link is in the description. We would also encourage you to support us. If you find our content something.
Yeah.